Question 16. What are the temperature coefficient effects of a preamplifier? Should cartridge characteristics be considered, or do I need to also consider the temperature response of a preamplifier? Answer. The contribution of the preamplifier to temperature coefficient is negligible. It recommended to always use the microphone and preamplifier system specifications. Question 17. Is the temperature coefficient linear beyond the IEC 61094 working class microphone required limits of minus 10 degrees Celsius to plus 50 degrees Celsius? Answer. Yes. The temperature coefficient is linear beyond these limits and has been tested to be consistent between minus 40 degrees Celsius and 150 degrees Celsius. Question 18. What is the most cost-efficient working-class pressure microphone for low amplitudes for sounds up to 10 kHz? Answer. All of PCB's half and one-quarter microphones have a flat frequency response from 4 Hz to 10 kHz. Model 377B11 is a half an inch pressure microphone. This is the most cost-effective option in the pressure response category for test and measurement quality microphones. Question 19. Can calibration corrections be provided for PCB microphones in an Excel format so software corrections can be done? Answer. Yes. The corrections for a PCB calibration certificate can be provided in Excel format. Question 20. What would cause a difference in results between a PCB model 130E20 array microphone and a working standard PCB model 378P02 microphone? Answer. The working standard model 378P02 is more stable in extreme environments than the low-cost model 130E's. Model 130 microphones will experience larger shifts in sensitivity caused by temperature, humidity, and atmospheric pressure. Both microphones should be calibrated in the test environment after they have stabilized. The accuracy of the measured data may be affected by the placement position and/or the geometry of the microphone and any reflections that may be present. The effect of the microphone itself on the sound field at the point of measurement. One quarter versus half microphone can alter the measurement. If this occurred, then change the position of the microphone and perform another measurement. If the error is only at higher frequencies, it is important to note that the specification of the 130E20 at 10 kHz is plus minus 2 dB. The model 377B02 is flatter to 20 kHz. Variations within tolerance may occur in specific instances. Question 21. Does a windscreen affect the sound field and output of the microphone? Answer. Windscreens can attenuate the signal at higher frequencies. Question 22. Are drop tests performed on PCB 377 series microphones? Answer. Yes. All PCB model 377 microphone designs are subjected to a drop test to ensure stability. Question 23. Is there a pre-polarized cost-effective solution to a half an inch externally polarized low noise microphone? Answer. Yes. PCB is the first to market a low-noise pre-polarized microphone, model 378A04. This matches the noise floor specification 6.5 bar of a half an inch externally polarized microphone. Question 24. Why do PCB 130E21, 130E22 and 130A23 array microphone models have different diameters than the 1 quarter of an inch 378 series microphones? Answer. These microphones were designed with different diameters to be drop-in replacements to other manufacturers' microphones. This eliminates the need to change holders or change setup. Question 25. Will improper grounding negatively impact the noise floor of a microphone? Answer. Yes. Noise can be introduced from the line power or from improper grounding. Question 26. Are the PCB model 377 series of microphones 100% tested? Answer. The model 377 series of microphones are 100% tested and each goes through a series of environmental stress relief tests and they are calibrated multiple times to characterize stability. Question 27. Does increased sound pressure cause a positive or negative voltage at the output terminal? Answer. When the incident pressure is positive on a pre-polarized microphone, the voltage output should be positive. Externally polarized microphones are 180 degrees out of phase with pre-polarized microphones due to where the charge is stored. On an externally polarized microphone, the voltage output will be negative when the incident pressure is positive. Question 28. Which PCB prepolarized condenser microphone offers the highest amplitude measuring capability? Answer. The 1/4 inch model 378A12 has the lowest sensitivity at 0.25 mV/PAR. This allows it to go to extremely high amplitudes. Question 29. Why do I measure a different sensitivity in the field than what is listed on your factory calibration certification? Answer. Changes in temperature, humidity and atmospheric pressure may change microphone sensitivity. This is why environmental conditions are stated on PCB calibration certificates. The sound field can also have a significant effect on the measured sound pressure at frequencies above 5 kHz. Be sure to use the correction curves that are specified for the sound field where the measurement is being performed. It is also noteworthy that these sound fields are often idealistic. In practice, a free field may not be complete free of reflections, or a random incidence field may not provide reflections from all directions. The mounting configuration of the microphone and objects near the microphone can affect the measured response even when located behind the microphone. Every configuration is different. Signal conditioning and data acquisition equipment can affect the sound measurement by limiting the dynamic range or attenuating the signal at different frequencies. Question 30. What is the anticipated impact of using a microphone at 6290 featuring above sea level? Answer. As static pressure increases, sensitivity goes down. Higher pressure means higher air density, which increases the acoustic impedance on surface of the diaphragm and in the gap between the diaphragm and the backplate. This has an effect on displacement. At 6290 feet, the barometric pressure is 47 kilopascals, which is a change of minus 54 kilopascals. If we apply that to the pressure correction, the result is minus 54 kilopascals by minus 0.013 decibels slash kPa equals 0.70 decibels Ray 1 volt slash Pa.
Hello.